Hello everybody and welcome back. We are now going to be diving into the archetype of Cancer, the fourth archetype in the zodiac and the first archetype that is related to the element of water. So just a little quick recap, we've gone through Aries, which is the initiation of life, come through to Taurus, which speaks to our first relationship and experience of the physical material plane, and then we came to Gemini, which is the first experience of the mind, of the intellect, of making sense of things, and then Cancer, the first experience of the emotion. And that is why Cancer is considered to be probably the most emotionally sensitive and vulnerable archetype. And naturally, we can immediately see where certain health problems might come from, considering that Cancer is so sensitive to the emotions and the environment of the people around Cancer, but also to themselves. Cancer, if you look at the glyph, it's looking like this. It's holding the energy of the mother and the child. And the thing with Cancer is that there is many lessons around learning how to develop this healthy mother-child relationship. Sometimes I can find the Cancerian energy allowing the fears, the insecurities, the doubt, the worry of the inner child to overtake Cancer's ability to have more of a rational and practical understanding of its environment. This is definitely dangerous because what it can lead to is not only somewhat irrational behavior and reactivity, but then it can also lead to a lot of unnecessary stress and pressure on the physical health and well-being of the body. And it is well known that Cancerians' tendency to worry, and also I'm going to say tendency towards codependency, which is taking on board other people's emotional responsibilities as your own, can definitely lead to certain physical health disorders in the body, right? And so when it comes to Cancer, through more of this spiritual, energetic lens, I want to give you permission, Cancer, to really embrace your love and your passion for family, for home, and for sentimental acts of care and nurture in this lifetime. It is so important for you to have people in your life that just feel nurturing and gentle and safe to be around. And I know that you are that person for the people in your life as well, and that is why you deserve it in return. But of course, when we are so caring, we can also very much take on everybody else's stuff on our own shoulders. And the first thing I want to say about that, Cancer, is that it is not your responsibility. The thing that I want to dispel here, a little bit of an illusion actually, is that sometimes we think taking on board somebody else's stuff as our own is the best way we can help them, when really what we end up doing is actually feeding into a lower vibration of that person, because we're actually inhibiting that person from figuring their shit out for themselves. Excuse my language. but also what you end up doing is you're taking yourself away from focusing on filling up your own cup. And it is so important for you to keep your cup full. If you have come back in with Cancerian dominance in this lifetime, it is because the soul has decided that it is very necessary for you to be focusing on self-healing, self-love, self-care, and nurture. And the healthiest Cancerian people I know are actually very good at putting their needs first. And nobody else is going to do that for you. Putting your needs first is so important for your health and your well-being. And it's only from there that you can actually tend to the healing of others in the way that you desire to. Because you are a natural healer. You are naturally attuned to the needs and how you can meet the needs of the people around you. But first, we need to make sure that your own needs are getting met. When it comes to the physical rulership in the body for Cancer, we're now moving down from this area, which was all Gemini, and we're moving to the breasts. Boop, boop, boop. Of course, it's very motherly, very nurturing here with the beautiful breasts. And so, of course, beautiful Cancer is ruling the breasts. Interestingly enough, Cancer is also ruling the uterus. Cancer rules anything that is actually moist in the body, such as the mouth, the salivary glands, as well as the moist the moistness of the vagina, can I say. Cancer is also going to be ruling the stomach, the upper digestion, as well as the way that we process fats in the body. So when it comes to certain health issues with Cancer, immediately we can see that there might be a little bit of manifestation around issues with digestion. Cancers are known for being the emotional eaters of the zodiac. They are naturally ruled by Mother Moon. And so there is, you know, whenever we're feeling emotionally overwhelmed, Cancer does tend to reach out for some kind of soothing. Naturally, because there's this very maternal and motherly energy about the Cancerian archetype. And if you aren't finding ways to give yourself this healing and this soothing, and you're giving it out to others all the time, naturally you're going to turn to something like food to self-soothe. And this is something that, of course, we have to be careful of. If you are feeling emotionally overwhelmed, yes, you might be prone to a little bit of irritable bowel syndrome or some kind of digestive problems, as well as it might actually even slow down your ability to be processing fats in a healthy way in the body. Cancer, also because it's ruled by the moon, has a lot to do with water retention as well. And so we might there find a direct correlation between the state of our emotions and water retention in the body. Also because Cancer is ruling the uterus and a lot to do with you know, our cycles. It's ruled by the moon, right? It's got a lot to do with our period. If you aren't taking care of your emotional well-being, then you might be more prone to having quite troublesome periods and different kinds of issues with your cycle as well. So for you, like for everybody, but for you specifically, it is all coming back to your emotions and how well you are validating, you are taking care, you are holding space, you are processing your emotions, but also not allowing yourself to get fully drawn into them and sucked into them to the point that it inhibits you from going out and taking practical action in the world. Okay, so there's always going to be a point that it comes to, Cancer, where we've done enough sitting and feeling, and then it's time to get up and get going again, even if it feels a little bit uncomfortable and scary. Sometimes a shadow of the Cancerian energy can be becoming so overly sensitive that we choose to no longer engage in the external world in a healthy way. We choose to stay home. We choose to stay attached to everything that is seeming safe and secure in the moment. And again, this can sometimes cause a little bit more harm than good. There can also be a certain health ailment towards maybe kidney stones, gallbladder stones with the Cancerian dominance in the birth chart, as well as, of course, nervousness, anxiety, and then even potentially like chills in the body. So we're wanting to make sure that the body temperature is being regulated in a very healthy way. But what I want to say for you, Cancer, Cancerians, is if you are getting sick, it is probably a pretty clear sign that you're overgiving and you're overtending to other people's needs above your own. And so you're getting physically ill because your body's saying, I need you to focus on me and put me first right now. Mm-hmm. Thank you for being the permission for sensitivity and vulnerability in this world. We need you, and I want you to know that this world is very desensitized, and we need you to remind us what it means to care for one another, to nurture one another, and what the ultimate meaning of family and tribe really is, which we have become quite disconnected from in today's society. Mwah.